the pairs medals decided. This is now time for the men's solo. It's time for the free skate. And we've got 18 skaters preparing themselves indoors to get the excitement underway. And it promises to be a really interesting battle, I think, this one, Petra.
Absolutely. And the lead after the show program is Jacob Santrus, the US American. But it is just, I would say, a tiny lead ahead of Adam Hagara, the Slovakian guy. And I would say up to the sixth place after the short program, they have really the big opportunity to get a medal here.
Yes, so everyone, yeah. So the sixth last skaters who will come up onto the ice have a chance. It's going in groups. So we've got group one. We're going to see Rio Nakata go in group one.
This is a surprise. It's not just for us, for him, of course, too, because he was the, I would say, top favorite after his gold at the Junior Grand Prix final. But then things in the short program
badly wrong in the short program.
Yes.
So the positives is that we get to see him early on, although his chances of winning a medal, unfortunately, are gone.
But I am sure that he will jump into the top 10 or maybe in the top 6 or 5 as possible with his ability of skating. But who we see? Who we see? He is already the second skater on the ice then in the first group.
So, yeah. So the groups have been regrouped on their scores from the short program.
Yeah, the last 6 after the short program are the first 6 to skate the free program now. We see 11 elements, so a maximum of 7 jump elements. One has to be an axel jump. Then we have maximum of 3 jump combinations or 2 jump combination and 1 jump sequence. Then we have a maximum of 3 spins. One must be a spin combination. Then we have 1 spin with a flying entry and 1 spin with only 1 position. And then we have the choreographic sequence. These are the elements that are required in the free skate.
Let me see. And we can see the start list here. And we were talking there, Rio Nakata going second. Jacob Sanchez, the leader after the short program, will go last in that third group.
That was an impressive performance of him in the short program. And after very good programs in the pairs competition this morning, we really hope for more exciting programs to come. Here he is, Rio Nakata, the young boy from Japan, 15 years old. In the Junior Grand Prix final, he was second in the short program, but then he showed or performed a long program that was amazing, absolutely amazing, without any little mistake. That was perfect. We will definitely see a quadruple jump of him in training sessions. He is not just jumping at quadruple toe. He already executes a quadruple salchow and a quadruple loop. Very talented young guy. And now we're really curious if he, I would say, can bounce back so with a good long program.
If anything, the pressure is completely off.
Yeah, you just can win. And now they are on the ice for their presentation. Representing
Sweden, Elias Syed. So getting things underway will be Elias Syed from Sweden. Representing Japan, Rio Nakata. And there he is, Rio Nakata. What can he produce? From Ukraine, Vadim Novikov.
representing France, Gianni Montilla.
From France, Gianni Montilla.
Latvia 선수입니다. Representing Latvia, Kirill Korkak.
Kirill Korkak from Latvia.
Estonia 선수입니다. Representing Estonia, Yegor Martsenko.
Yegor Martsenko from Estonia will be the final skater in this first group. Then we will have some ice resurfacing. 20-minute break or so before the second group comes out. So let's have a look at Elias Syed from Sweden. He's from Uppsala. Did he not go to school with a friend of yours?
No, not. Yes. I have a friend in Uppsala, and that was his son. And I sent him a video of his short program and said, "Oh, this is amazing. I've never seen him skating, but I know that he's very determined and spends a lot of hours
so hopefully
with training."
They're now watching him.
Yeah.
Oh, we've talked about Ryo Nakata already.
Oh, this was just a triple axel out of nothing.
Yes, well, there we go. That's what he's got. He was born in Cardiff, as the announcer's just saying.
Yeah, he has a British mum.
ISU Junior Grand Prix in Bangkok, representing Japan, Ryo Nakata.
Completely new situation, but this is the thing the young boys, the young girls, they have to learn too.
From Odessa in Ukraine, it's Vadim Novikov.
Skater is a music lover who enjoys playing the piano and guitar in his free time. Ranked 15th place at the 2023 ISU Junior Grand Prix Cup of Austria. Representing Ukraine, Vadim Novikov.
The French guy with the Italian name.
Gianni Montilla, yeah.
18 years old, ranked third place at the 2023 Metropole Nice Côte d'Azur. Representing France, Gianni Montilla.
This is hobbies as moto and skating. I think motorbiking or motocross. Next up, it's Kirill Korkats from Latvia.
The 17-year-old skater enjoys walking and reading. He received his personal best score at the 2023 ISU Junior Grand Prix Solidarity Cup. Representing Latvia, Kirill Korkats.
And there is one more in this group.
Martsenko from Estonia.
The skater is also 17 years old.
Final skater in this first group.
ISU Junior Grand Prix in Budapest, representing Estonia, Yegor Martsenko.
So as they go through the warm-up, what can we expect from this free skate?
When I look into the planned program elements, at least a lot of triple-triple combinations, and from Ryo Nakata, of course, the quad toe. We have the same after 1 minute and 45 seconds. We have that second half bonus. What's maybe interesting to know is that of all the triples and quads we see, only two can be executed twice, and then, of course, they have to be shown in a combination or in a jump sequence. Just the double axel can be shown twice, that's not a problem. Already see a lot of triples in the warm-up now. The boys or the young men are ready to compete.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It looks effortless.
Just, yeah, effortless.
Skaters, your warm-up has ended. Please clear.
So warm-up ended and time to get things underway. First out onto the ice from Uppsala in Sweden, it's Elias Syed. Some last minute words of advice.
The 15th after the short program.
Representing Sweden,
so a score of 54.57 in the short program.
It was almost 10 points below his personal best in the short program.
And in this free skate, he will skate to Remember and Protectors of the Earth, arranged by Cedric Tour.
Some problems at the beginning, first with the combination and now the loop just double and not in a triple version. Jump sequence, triple load, double axel, double toe. Ah, it was planned as another jump combination, and he opened up the loads to a double one. Thank you.
Aliyah Syed of Sweden gets things underway here for the men's single free skate.
Yeah, he has some problems today, unfortunately, with his jumps. Lots of them doubled instead of triple jumps, then one jump combination missing. It's not a problem because you have in the long program, they say it's a maximum of three jump combinations or two jump combinations and one jump sequence. But there was just one sequence that was really nice. The triple at the beginning. I think we see it here again. Flip was quite okay, but then maybe it would have been better if he had executed a double toe after the triple flip. Then here, that should have been a triple loop. The flip was nice.
There's some positive stuff in there.
Yes, of course.
Syed.
That was the jump sequence.
See his ankle working furiously on the landings there to keep balanced.
But you see he changed his program. He did another jump combination with a triple cycle double toe. It's like that 50-50 face. 50% happy, 50% unhappy. Yeah.
Yeah, I think he can be content with his performance. How's your Swedish, Petra?
I wanted to ask you the same right now.
Virtually non-existent. Here are the scores. So a total score of 150.
He has earned a total combined score
and 95 scored for the free skate.
Representing Japan, Ryo Nakata.
Well, fasten your seatbelts because Ryo Nakata is taking to the ice. Disappointment in the short program. Pressure is completely off. And what can he produce in the free skate? And he will be performing to music at the James Bond melody.
Yeah, it's a really nice program. So let's enjoy this skate. Speed is up for the quad toe, the first element that is planned. But that was nice, triple axel, triple toe.
I've spent a lifetime in, and I always care. Wow. Well, it wasn't faultless, but it was a thing of beauty. What an incredible young athlete.
Yeah. But you see it in his face. He's not satisfied with his performance. But of course, there were some really nice elements in it, in this program. And it...
The triple axel.
It looks so effortless. So yeah. It, like nothing. Like you can do it just... Like this, both of them, one in a combination, and then another one as a solo jump.
The quad toe didn't quite stick, though, at the very beginning of the program.
Yeah, problems with the landing, but it was no fall at all. And I was quite impressed with this jump combination, that he could manage to execute a triple psycho at the end, after the problems at the beginning of the flip. It was that hard landing. But this was incredible.
Well, he's not quite the finished product yet, but
no.
In 2-3 years, looking at potentially one of the best skaters in the world.
Well, we see, yeah. At the moment, the best skater in the world is a Japanese with Shoma Uno, twice world champion. Oh, we remember Yusuru Hanyo, twice Olympic champion. So the Japanese are very good in single skating, if it's man, if it's woman.
What did you think of the choreo?
I think this is something he has to improve. So his artistic impression. So this is definitely room to improve. But this guy just got 15 years old, so in September. So he's so young. And like you said, normally he needs that time to be then the... 100% athlete.
Everything and showman.
That everything comes together. Because technically he's already on a very high level. Like said in the warm-up, he already, in the training, he already executes a triple psycho and a quadruple psycho on a quad loop. So in total, 3 quads. Yeah, okay. That's far away from his best, personal best of 160 that was at the Junior Grand Prix final.
But it takes a lead, and that lead will stand
for a while.
For a very long time in this competition.
I think up until the last group.
Yeah. How high can he climb? Potentially top six.
We see.
We will see.
Representing Ukraine, Vadim Novikov.
Next up from Ukraine, it's Vadim Novikov.
14th after the short program.
And he will skate to Rhapsody in Blue by George Gershwin.
So he chooses the classic music. No triple axel at the beginning like planned. Now I'm interested what he's doing, because that should have been a combination. Okay. He changed that. Should have been a jump sequence, and now it was the more difficult jump combination. And okay. And here now another combination with a triple flip. So he has his three jump combinations.
So he's changed that mid-program.
Yes, they can do that. They just have to think about that it's not allowed to show a jump more than twice, and one has to be executed in a combination if they repeat it.
Vadim Novikov from Ukraine. Personal best score in the free program is a 156.
Representing Ukraine, Vadim Novikov.
Oh, sorry, no, it is a 101.
101, yes. Yeah. Season's best, 99.
Yeah.
But he's quite happy. He can be. Completely different skater, like, of course, Rio Nakata, not just because of the height, because of his skating skills, too. Will be interesting then at the end to compare the program components.
Of course, we don't see them.
So the composition, the presentation, and then, of course, the skating skills. This was nice, the triple-triple combination at the beginning of his program. And this was the problem. Normally, he wanted to show here already the combination with an Euler and a triple cycle. The landings. That is something you really should focus on in the future. Greetings to the whole family.
And going into second place with a 105.
It's a new PB.
That's good. Yeah, good. PB there in the free skate. 160 is the total.
Representing France, Gianni Motilla.
Next up from France, it's Gianni Motilla.
Great heart cry by Dries. I love it.
Well, apart from that penultimate jump that was planned as a double axel.
But he wanted to show a triple cycle. It was just a single one.
The jumps were good.
We had the same problem like with the skater before, the landings. Sometimes a bit too much on the toe pick landed, so not a lot of speed then in the landing.
He's very, very happy with that performance.
Yes, but he can be. He's more the jumper, so another skater who needs a bit more of artistic flair. That would be nice. Because the music was really good, really nice choice. I would love to see that in another perspective. I'm not sure if it was the right edge with this triplets. It was really nice.
Yeah, I love a bit of a hydro glide.
Yeah, during the choreo sequence. And that was the single.
Yes, that was the penultimate one.
Yeah.
Where it went slightly wrong. But other than that...
Yeah.
Got to say, you're going to be pretty happy with that performance.
Good. And he's happy, smiling. Coach too.
The scores, please. France. Gianni Motilla 선수의 free skating 점수는
third place. Score of 104.47 in the free and a total of 156.26.
Total combined score of 156.
Close to his PB.
Points, which puts him in third place.
In the overall score. And there are two skaters to come in this group.
And the first of them is from Latvia. Kirill Korkats. From Riga in Latvia. Part of the Jelgavar Ice Sports School. And he will be skating to I Love You by Woodkid.
Softly watching you, all your eyes betray what burns inside you.
Cause I love you. Is there anything I could do?
Kirill Korkats from Latvia.
He had a PB in the short program that was a really good day for him. But sometimes, and I think it was maybe the same like in the short program, that he under-rotated the second jump, the toe, after the triple flip.
His personal best score for the free skate is 89.31.
Very tall skater, the tallest of the competition with 190. Yeah, it was under-rotated, the toe. But it's difficult when you're 190, so he's 2 meters on the ice with his skates. Oh, and then the single. Same problem like the skater before, that he opened one of his jumps. Was there any fall yet? Not. No fall so far in this first group. That's good.
A couple of hand downs, but no actual...
Or maybe single or double jumps, but no fall at all. That's good.
As we await the scores... Judges are keeping us waiting here a little bit.
I think they will double check the jumps because of the rotation, if they were fully rotated or not. We just saw it with the toe. I wasn't sure with another jump, but you really have to watch it then in a super slow motion.
Scores coming through now. And fifth place, 91.07 in the free skate. A total score of 144.43.
He has earned a total combined score of 144.43 points, which currently puts him in fifth place.
첫 번째 그룹 마지막 선수 에스토니아 선수입니다.
Representing Estonia, Yegor Martsenko.
Out of Tallinn, Estonia, it's Yegor Martsenko.
He had a lot of problems in his short program, so let's hope that this free skate will be better for him.
And he is skating to Who Wants to Live Forever by the Tenors.
Unfortunately, the fall should have been the triple flip Euler triple Saito combination.
Well, it started well from Yegor Martsenko, but he kind of ran out of steam a little bit there towards the end and with the fall in the combination.
Then he hadn't had the three combinations he wanted to present. At the beginning, I thought, wow, he's in a really good mood today. But the moment the second half started, the moment you get that bonus for the jump element, he got problems. Not just with the fall, some jumps were then under-rotated too. Solid begin. And here the combination. Triple Lutz, triple toe. Not fully rotated the toe.
Hand down there on the yeah. triple flip.
It should have been already the combination.
And that was where the fall came.
Yeah.
It was supposed to be a triple flip, Euler, and then yeah. Salco.
And then, of course, he tried it then with the Lutz. And all of the jumps under-rotated, and he couldn't land this combination in a proper way.
Giving a wave to the folks back home in Tallinn.
Well, there's a lot to check, especially the under-rotated jumps. There were a couple of ones here in this performance. But he should be happy with the beginning of his program.
And he goes into sixth place.
Yeah, he stays.
Yeah, stays in sixth place, 87.56. He was in sixth coming into this free skate.
Yeah.
And he has stayed where he was.
The 18th place at the end for him, for Yegor Matsenko.
So that wraps up Group 1, and we should be able to see the scores on the doors. Rio Nakata will obviously shoot up the leaderboard. The question is, how far can he go?
Yeah.
It wasn't a perfect performance by Rio Nakata. Not a PB for him in the free skate.
But it was a very good one.
But it was great to watch. We're going to take a short break. The Zamboni is already out on the ice, and we'll be back in around about 20 minutes' time.
관객 여러분, 청소년 선수들을 향한 뜨거운 응원을 부탁드립니다. 선수 호명 후 프로그램 음악이 시작되기 전까지는 같이 정숙을 유지해 주시기 바랍니다. 또한 경기가 시작된 후 자리를 이동하는 것은 선수들의 경기력에 영향을 미칠 수 있습니다. 선수들의 프로그램이 음악이 진행되는 동안에는 이동을 금해 주시기 바랍니다. 여러분, 두 번째 웜업 그룹이 입장합니다. Please welcome the second warm-up to the end.
So, time to get things back underway again here at the Gangwon Ice Arena, the men's free skate.
The second group is on the ice.
Aurelien Charret of Switzerland out of the skate club Bern.
Representing Canada, David Lee.
David Lee from Vancouver.
Georgia 선수입니다. Representing Georgia, Konstantin Supatashvili.
And the Georgian, Supatashvili.
Representing Great Britain, Tal McRae.
Tal McRae, born in London, skating in Portland, Oregon.
일본 선수입니다. Representing Japan, Haru Kakiuchi.
Haru Kakiuchi.
Nishinoma,
Nomiya.
Georgi Pavlov.
From Forsch in Switzerland, it's Georgi Pavlov.
You have 6 minutes time for your warm-up.
So 6 minutes of warm-up. We'll get to have a look at more detail. We start with the first of the Swiss in this group, Aurelien Chevret. He has 56-55 from the short program.
So the last he got that spot in the second group after the short program.
Personal best in the free skate of a 107.72.
16살로 산악 자전거 타기가 취미인 캐나다 선수
David Lee from Canada trains at the Connaught Skating Club in Richmond, which is just the south of Vancouver, with coaches Aileen and Keegan Murphy.
Representing Canada, David Lee. Georgia 선수는 작년 9월에 열린 주니어 그랑프리 시리즈 이스탄불 대회에 참가한 바 있습니다. This skater was born in St. Petersburg, 16 years of age, and achieved his personal best score at the 20th.
There are a lot of skaters from Russia who are competing for Georgia.
Konstantin Supastashvili. He does have a Georgian name.
Yes.
영국 선수인데요.
Very often they have two nationalities because of mom and dad, or and he was great in the short program, the first on the ice, but with a top performance.
Yeah, scored a PB in the short program. His personal best in free skate is a 95.85, but if he can do the same as he did in the short. Kakiuchi. Haru Kakiuchi from Japan. Well, this is the one with the kind of eclectic hobbies of collecting rocks and stones and old
yes.
coins.
You already were impressed about that in the short program.
I was, yeah. It's not something that a 16-year-old should be doing.
But
really.
Normal is boring. And then we have another Swiss woman in this group. I mean, not woman, men, of course.
Georgi Pavlov from Switzerland, also born in St. Petersburg.
I was a day too early. Tomorrow, the winds are skating again.
So those are the six. And they are going through their warm-up. Quite a big gap between this group and the top group. From the person from the short program, 61.97 is the highest in.
But it's not
in this group.
Yeah.
And 67.
And 56.
66.
Aurélien was 56 and the top skater in this group was 61, so 5 points in between.
And then we've got Ryo Nakata, who is leading the
by almost
the
40 points. Yeah. But okay, that was...
Can any of these group beat
no.
Nakata?
I wouldn't say no.
It's fairly confident, but I think it's a good prediction there.
No, no, no. I think he will be in the lead till the last group. Like that, maybe a top five ranking is possible. It was not the perfect program, you mentioned it, but it was a very good one with a lot of high-level
Well, yeah, just
elements.
Looking back to Nakata and his the scores that he got, he only got 5.97 for the quad toe because he didn't stick it. But if he had...
But look how many points he got for this triple axel, triple toe.
13.89.
Yeah, including the GUEs because it was brilliant. Sometimes you have skaters when they show a quad combination, a quad and a triple... Then they have almost 20 points. So just with one element.
Yeah, you can see how those points racked up.
Some problems with the landing of the triple axel. But it's just a warm-up.
Warm up over, and we are ready to go. First out on the ice for Switzerland, it's Aurélien Chevre. From Neuchâtel, now skating out of the skate club in Bern.
Just a short info for all of our viewers who haven't been with us in the first group. They have to perform a maximum of 7 jump elements. We have a maximum of 3 spins, and there is one choreo sequence.
And the music, Miss Mephisto's Lullaby, Sweet Dreams. Interesting choice of music there.
Yes.
Sweet Dreams. Well, it didn't turn into a nightmare, but there were a few problems.
Yes.
With the performance.
Yes, especially with his chums. Some double, like planned. Triple, then already at the beginning, the problems with the triple lutz with the landing. He's now one of a, I would say, of a few skaters we've seen so far who has not that artistic flair. You would like to see, of course, on the ice too, like we've seen, with, of course, with Rio Nakata. And we definitely will see with the other skaters up to come. But it's like you said, the music was kind of special in this program. But that's like the costumes. It's... You have different tastes, and that's okay. Just could avoid to put his hands down like here. triple toe, double toe. I think to compete on a higher level, he really has to work on his triples and then, of course, to show a triple axel or a triple-triple combination.
A work in progress.
Yeah.
But that's what the Youth Olympic Games is all about.
Absolutely. And it's already a big success to compete here in Gangwon for these young skaters. He's 17 and he had a personal best in the short program already. And he has fun in competing it. Here you see, he's smiling.
His PB in the free skate is a 107.
And it's another PB. It's
yeah,
good.
So you can't do any better than that. Going into second position behind Ryo Nakata.
He has earned a total combined score of 165.55 points, currently placing him in second place. Canada 선수입니다. Representing Canada, David Lee.
David Lee from Canada, next out onto the ice. And he will be skating to La Bohème by Charles Aznavour.
Ça ne veut plus rien dire du tout.
David Lee of Canada. Putting all of his combination jumps into the very first part yes. of the program.
Yes. To get more points, normally at least one combination or jump sequence should be in the second half because of the bonus. Some of them, of the big skaters, show twice of them. So, but I think we discussed it. It has a reason.
Yeah, I mean, I think the reason is that he's put them in early because he... Yeah. You know, he struggles with them and he wants to get them while he's fresh.
Yeah.
And you were saying that the height of yeah. the jumps was perhaps not there.
Yeah.
You didn't like his outfit. I quite like his outfit. It's supposed to be kind of like French artist, isn't it? Yeah. Like La Bohème. It fits with the music.
Yeah, but I would have loved maybe a dark blue pants then. So, but okay, it's like the music, like we discussed before. That is a special taste. That's okay. Yeah, under-rotated, the second jump. And this is the problem. When you don't have the height, then it's always difficult to really fully rotate the jumps. Here, he already landed the loop, and then...
Yeah, I thought he was just going to skate out of that one.
This was fine. This was without any problems, the Lutzier. A very small skater with his 149 centimeters. He was the second at the Canadian Junior Championships.
Keegan and Eileen are the coaches back at home. And second place, 118.57 in yeah. the free skate.
Now, of course, everyone should be in the lead if they want to stay with their place. Of course, they lose all of one because Nakata is in the lead.
A good performance there for Lee of Canada.
Representing Georgia, Konstantin Supatashvili.
Konstantin Supatashvili from Georgia. The music, Where's My Love and Who Will Save You Now?
Will we now see another triple axel?
Thank you.
Just come home.
Apart from that fall on the triple axel, the very beginning, that was a great program from Konstantin Kvitashvili.
Really, really good. All of the other jumps, very, very nice executed. With a good knee in the landings. Yes, not that speed I would love to have, or what I would love to see from him, but he was very concentrated and he fought back after that fall. Really good.
Yeah, he can be happy with that performance. Has a personal best in the free of 122.88.
Yeah, from the season, from the Junior Grand Prix in Istanbul. There's the axle. It was slightly under-rotated. That was then the double one.
Looks triple toe.
That was really good.
Yeah.
The triple combination. Yeah. Collected a lot of points with the other elements he showed in this program after the fall with the triple axel.
So you feel it's not going to be good enough to take the lead away from Ryo Nakata, but it's definitely, there's a big gap there between first and second.
It was just 3 points after the short program between the two. And of course, the quality of Ryo Nakata is on another level. We have to be honest.
So a strong second place for now, we're expecting.
Yeah, definitely.
The scores, please.
Oh, third.
Yeah.
Third. So 116.25. Just 1 point in it. David Lee hangs on to second place.
It's a bit a surprise for me because I, to be honest, these jumps had a better quality than David Lee with some under-rotated jumps.
But just the 1 point.
Yeah. So, but now I'm curious about this guy. He was so good in the short program. Tom McRae, the British one.
Tom McRae skating out of Portland, Oregon. And Tao will skate to Jesus Christ Superstar by Andrew Lloyd Webber.
Yes.
After all, I've tried for 3 years. Seems like 90. Why then am I scared to finish what I started? What you started, I didn't start it. God, thy will is hard, but you hold every cup. I will drink your cup of poison. Please take me now before I change my mind.
Tom McRae of Great Britain.
Today he struggled a bit.
A lot of expression in that performance.
Representing Great Britain, Tom McRae.
And maybe didn't have the degree of difficulty in some of the jumps.
Yes. And the smile is missing, we saw in the short program. But now it's here again.
Well, has a PB in the free skate of 95.85.
Which is not that high, by the way.
No. So we're fully expecting a PB here from this.
And he has a really good coach with Michal Prasina. This was good. But we have the same, like with many skaters here so far, the triple axel is missing. And this is, of course, a key jump when you want to compete for the, I would say, first 7 to 8 places in a competition like that. And the top skaters in the juniors category already show quads. The landings. He had some problems with the landings. This was a fine in the jump sequence. But look at here again after the double axel. Always
slightly off axis, yes. Off balance.
They all have their lucky charms.
So currently David Lee lies in second place. Ryo Nakata way out in front.
I think he will lose a few places. Which is good that he has a new PB.
Yeah, 112.
That is an amazing 12. PB for him.
Taking fourth place with 171.61.
He loses 3 places, but okay, he should be happy with his personal best in both of the programs, short and free skate.
일본 선수입니다. Representing Japan, Haru Kakiuchi.
And I just mentioned the quads, and this guy wants to start with a quad toe in combination with a triple one. Fingers crossed.
So it is Haru Kakiuchi of Japan, and he will be skating to Wake Me Up by Avicii.
Missed.
I can't tell where the journey went, but I know where to start. They tell me I'm too young to understand. They say I'm caught up in a dream. Well, life will pass me by if I don't open up my eyes. So that's fine by me. So let me up when it's all over.
Haru Kakiuchi of Japan produces a great performance, but like his teammate, unable to land the quad toe loop at the beginning of the routine.
But at least he tried it. That was good. I am surprised that he is able to execute a quad toe, but not a triple axel. All of the other triples, okay, the landing of the loop was a bit shaky. But a very nice, I think, where we see it again, triple-triple-double combination in this program. You see some of the skaters, they are wearing gloves. It was not fully rotated too. It was the problem, and this was the shaky landing of the loop. And here the combination. This was good.
triple toe loop.
But normally, for Japanese skaters, they have that kind of, I would say, special thing on the ice, this artistic flair.
We got the crowd going in the choreo sequence when, yeah, you know, there was a bit of
that was good.
Clapping
the
along.
Choreo was nice, but I would love to see it all over the program, not just there. We already talked about yesterday and the day before how many good skaters they have. He's just the fourth best junior in Japan and the 18th in the seniors category. And this was already executing a quad. In Germany, we don't ever even have one of them.
So, are we going to see Japan in first and second?
I think so.
Rio Nakata sits on 198.
Japan. 하루 카키우치 선수의 프리스케이팅 점수는
and Kakiuchi
yes,
does go
like
in
this.
To second, 185.88. So that's a big gap between David Lee, who's now pushed down into third place.
Currently placing him, but still a big gap place. To Rio Nakata.
Yep.
30 points.
두 번째 조 마지막 선수. Representing Switzerland, Georgi Pavlov.
Switzerland is really good presented here at the Youth Olympic Games.
Georgi Pavlov will be the last of this group. And he will skate to Ordinaire by Bruno Pelletier.
Je chante, c'est pour qu'on m'entende. Et quand je crie, sois tous des frères. C'est pour ça qu'on est sur la terre.
Well, nice work there from Georgi Pavlov of Switzerland. Strong performance.
Really nice. Really nice. Good jumps. Nicely programmed. Another French program here after Charles Aznavour, we've already seen.
I think he can be very proud of that performance.
The second best junior in Switzerland. And he already had a personal best in the short program. A very strong one, 7 points over his old score. And I can imagine that he will have a new one now in this free skate too. Strong start with a triple-double combination. Very good triple flip here. And here another Lutz.
Coach is happy.
He should be.
Yeah.
He for sure can improve the levels of his spins. There's room to improve.
Goes into third place, a total of 1-7-8.
Like we thought, yeah.
Just edges David Lee down.
Another 7 points on top on this PB, like in the short program. Really good. Congrats to Georgi Pavlov.
Yeah, he's really improved. So that wraps up the second group, and you can see the standings. Ryo Nakata racing up the ranking board, and it's Japan 1 and 2, but there is the final group to come. 6 more skaters, and we will introduce them onto the ice now. The question is, how long can Ryo Nakata hang on to that top spot? There's a big gap now between the points scored in the short program between the second group and the third group.
Representing Italy, Rafael Francesco Z. Representing Republic of Korea, Hyun-Gyup Kim.
Big cheer for the Korean.
Representing Slovakia, Adam Hagara.
Adam Hagara lying on 75 points.
Representing United States of America, Jacob Sanchez.
And Jacob Sanchez will be last to skate, the leader after the short program.
Skaters, you have
those two around about 4 points clear of the third place skater. So we look at Tonghi Tian of the People's Republic of China, 67.08 in the short program. He has a personal best in the free skating of 134.
2023 ISU Junior Grand Prix Cup of Austria, representing People's Republic of China.
Fourth place there in Linz at the Junior Grand Prix there. Yan Hao Li of New Zealand, born in Beijing, grew up in Auckland.
The skater who loves music was born in Beijing, China, currently the junior national champion in his history, in his country, representing New
Zealand. The national junior champion in New Zealand. And the Italian, Rafael Francesco Zich, born in Hanoi in Vietnam.
A really interesting skater, especially when it comes to the artistic impression and a lot of components, a lot of high value in the short program.
A personal best in the free of 131. Skates out of the ice club in Torino. And lying in bronze medal position is Kim Hyun-yeom.
But he has the opportunity maybe to jump to the lead because he was the second in the Junior Grand Prix final.
So born in Seoul, lives in Incheon, which is just to the south of Seoul. It's basically the dock city, which is where the airport is. Handy for traveling, I guess. Adam Hagara from Slovakia.
Another strong performance of this guy in the short program after he won his first Slovakian skater the bronze medal at the Junior Grand Prix final.
This skater is 17
has a PB
years old,
in the free skate of 148.
Also the national champion for three consecutive years, representing Slovakia, Adam Hagara.
And the last skater to take to the ice will be Jacob Sanchez from the USA, from Montgomery in New York State.
Another interesting costume, like in the short program. He was really good in the short program.
PB in the free, 133.
It's not that high like the others.
So the big question, I think, Petra, is can Ryo Nakata climb up the leaderboard and how long can he stay at the top?
Maybe. Let's see. How many points difference was it? Okay, Chong Tian had 67. He has 55 in the short prong. It was already 12 points. But maybe I would say fifth place is definitely possible. Maybe the fourth. We will see. But I think fifth. Rafaela had some problems with the jumps in the short program, but the program itself was really amazing, and the New Zealand guy, amazing too.
That's quite an outfit.
They already have, it's quite an outfit, but it fits because they just need a couple of steps and you see, okay, they can skate. And this is the difference now from this group to the other groups we've seen so far. Completely different attitude when they are coming on the ice. They want to say, hey, look at me. And this was an amazing quarto. Hopefully, he can deliver it because it would have been the first today.
That's the first one we've seen land cleanly today.
Yeah. But it's just a warm-up at the moment, you know. Can be different. Maybe this quad is the jump to the win at the end, to the victory. It was a lot of pressure, of course, on this young guy here. When you are one of the top favorites, then they want to see you win. Nice triple axle, like in the short program.
Well, warm up over.
Skaters, your warm up has ended. Please clear the ice.
And getting things underway in this final group will be Tong He Tian of the People's Republic of China. No quads planned for Tian. And he will skate to the Grand Piano Concerto by Victor Reyes. Thank you. Well, didn't go entirely to plan there for Tong He Tian of the People's Republic of China.
It started very well, so with a triple lutz, triple toe combination, and we thought, okay, wonderful start, let's continue like this. But then he already, the first problem started with the triple salchow at the end of the double axel Euler triple salchow combination.
And he put all three of those jump combinations in at the very beginning of the program.
Yeah, but he couldn't deliver it. Then he had to change his program because it was planned then directly after the triple loop, double toe. But problems in the landing with the triple loop. He executed it later, then it was fine. This was good. That was the start. That was the beginning of the program. Here, everything was good. And then out of the axis here and then...
triple salchow.
Yeah. And that was a wise decision not to jump a double toe.
So didn't get the combination there. So it was a triple loop, double toe planned. So just did the triple loop and then fitted it in later on.
Yeah. That was good. It was good that there was no fall at the first jump because then he would have executed the triple loop twice and that is not allowed. When you show an element twice, then one has to be in a combination. That's always a risk then.
Because he was planning on doing a single triple loop, so he just added the double toe loop to the end of it. So it's, it worked out.
Yeah. A double toe normally fits very easily to a triple when he has the feeling, okay, the landing is good, I can do that and collect more points. It's the second half and you have a combination. Of course, it's more points than just a single jump.
I guess that's the advantage of putting the combination jumps in at the beginning is that if you don't quite stick them, you can always fit them in later on at the end.
Yes, but normally, like already mentioned, in the seniors category, we normally see a lot of jump combinations and jump sequences in the second half. Very often, two of them.
So it's Japan in first and second. Ryo Nakata on 198 points. Haru Kakiuchi in silver medal position at 185. Is this good enough to dislodge either of those Japanese skaters? Not quite. Third place, 179.32. Just goes ahead of the Swiss skater, Georgi Pavlov.
79.32 points, which currently brings him to third place.
You see the 1 point deduction there. For the fall.
At the Sarko.
Representing New Zealand, Yan Hao Lee.
He had a... He was really good in the short program. Slightly missed the Junior Grand Prix final with two third places. In Bangkok and Osaka.
So Yan Hao Lee from New Zealand will skate to Garde Confidence by Romaric Laurence.
Another French music today. Speeds up for the triple axel.
Thank you.
Well, what a great performance for Yan Hao Lee of New Zealand. Absolutely nailed it. And the degree of difficulty by putting those jump combinations into the second half.
We just talked about that the good ones, they are showing two of them in the second half. He did it.
Indeed, he did. And it was a very, very good performance. Is it good enough to take the lead away from Ryo Nakata? It could well be.
I think it could be. It is maybe the triple axel was missing and Nakata showed it twice. But we have the components too and the skating. And all in all, that is my opinion. I love watching him skating more than Ryo Nakata. He has that kind of attitude on the ice from the very first second. And I said it in the short program already.
His positioning in the air is quite incredible. Just watch the jump.
Wonderful. That's not a lot of minus duties, no. Wonderful triple-triple combination. But the skating and the spin, so he has the whole package already. And he's 15 years old, like Nakata. And Nakata is good, but we discussed at the end about his artistic impression. And he is better in that. This was in the second half, the jump sequence. Skaters are allowed from these three jump combinations to show two combinations in one sequence, two or three jump combinations like they want, but just one sequence. And that was the last jump element of this program.
Well, it's good.
Really good.
The question is how good. There's a big lead. Ryo Nakata disappointing in the short program.
The position and the spins too. Very flexible guy. High levels and yeah. These are the pictures we love. When the skaters are so happy.
So this could be good enough for a medal. Can he take the lead away from Ryo Nakata? If he does,
he had almost
guaranteed a medal.
He had almost 13 points more in the short program than Nakata.
He's done it.
It's done it. It's a second very... Yeah, it's done.
140.83.
It's not... Yeah, it is 2 points less, almost 2 points less than Nakata in the free skate. That's okay for the triple axel. But you see what you can do without a triple axel at the end. He has showed one, but with the skating, with the components, absolutely well deserved.
Yan Hao Lee of New Zealand takes the lead.
Presenting Italy, Rafael Francesco Z.
And for Italy, it is Rafael Francesco Zic. And he will be skating to Silence of the Lambs.
And it continues with beautiful skating.
He's going to carve it up.
Yeah.
Ooh la la.
Oh, disappointment for Rafael Francesco Zic. It went wrong from the very beginning.
Yes, the first three elements are with big problems.
It was three from three, wasn't it?
And twice the triple axel.
Yeah.
The takeoff is a bit round of this triple axel, and this is always dangerous. And then the whole skating, of course.
Oh, what a shame.
It's not that good, and there will be a lot of deductions in the GOEs, and of course in the components then too for the presentation. And then, of course, here, this double loop. This is the moment normally as a skater when that is happening with the first three elements, then you have the feeling, oh shit, I have to do that until the very end, but I don't want to do that anymore. I want to leave the ice, yeah. This moment. That's the difference. So when the first element, okay, we saw it a couple of times today, it's not okay, and then you find the right answer, then it's okay. But the first three, that is really tough.
Yeah, yeah.
I like the show program more, the choreography. It was more impressive. But he is an extrovert skater. And we talk about figure skating. Art is so important here too. And it's not just the jumps. It's so much more.
The score is please.
Italia. La Paella Francesco.
And going into third place.
Yeah, Nakata in between.
So Nakata still hanging on to a medal position.
Yeah, but now we have three really strong men coming up.
Which currently brings him to third place.
And it starts with, I would say, maybe, not just maybe, with the strongest one of the three.
Well, the pressure is on the home skater here. Hyun Jung Kim of Korea.
Will we see a quad toe like we've seen in the warm-up? Hopefully.
Well, he's got it listed. Quad toe to start.
Yes. And I really hope that
this
would
is
be
it.
Yeah.
Kim Hyun Jung will skate to Requiem of a Dream.
In the Junior Grand Prix final, he had a fall at the Quarto in the long program. But there was the short program perfect. So maybe today it's vice versa.
Here it comes.
Yes, that's it. And that was so important now for the skate. And this music is so beautiful.
What an incredible performance from Hyun Jung Kim of Korea in front of his home crowd. Well, that is absolute perfection. He nailed that quad toe to start the program, and it just got better and better all the way through.
Yeah,
he's gone and done it.
I would say we've already seen the new Youth Olympic champion after that program. Of course, there are two more skaters to come, but this program was so unbelievably good. Amazing. And when you just think that about this quad toe at the beginning, the base value is 9.5 points, and he will get some GUEs on top. So we will have more than 10 points on the first jump already.
And Hagara from Slovakia and Sanchez from the USA don't have that.
No.
So...
And then two combinations or one sequence and combinations in the second half. So he collected a lot of points, especially with a triple-triple combination in the second half of the program. And it looked so effortless. Oh, just the jumps, the skating, the spins, everything.
Well, absolute perfection from start to finish, wasn't it, Petra?
Yeah, I loved it. I loved it. And
here we go.
Yeah. Yeah, this was wonderful. And I told you after the third element... He will nail it. And you are, wait, Petra. But he did it. I was sure, because with his triple jumps, he's always so safe. It was just the quad toe. He had a fall at the Junior Grand Prix final. And that was the reason why he couldn't win the title. He was in first after the short program. That was then the difference to Nakata, who jumped from the fourth to the first place.
I mean... It's hard to spot anything wrong with that.
No. No, it was nothing wrong. It was perfect. It was the perfect program. And he already has a very high personal best of 155.22. And I'm sure it will be more. Because it was perfect.
Well, that would be a massive lead if he did a personal best, wouldn't it?
And that in front of the home crowd.
Well,
that was his day today.
Like a diamond, he has shone under pressure.
And I'm sure he will be a senior next season. And I'm sure we will hear a lot of this skater in the future of Jung-Jung Kim. And it's incredible how he developed over the years. Last year was sixth at the World Juniors. And now he's... maybe winning the gold medal at the Youth Olympics.
Coach is crying.
Yes. He already has his crown on.
So the scores.
It will be the lead, but we have to have a look on the... Yes.
And it is the lead.
It's not a personal best, but...
147.45, a total score of 216. That is, well, that's 8 points ahead of Lee from New Zealand.
Brings him to first place.
A big lead.
But he has a medal. So we know at least the first medal winner.
Exactly.
With two to come.
Two to come. We have Adam Hagara coming up from Slovakia now. Hagara. Well, he has a PB in the free skate of 148.
And his season so far is incredible. With a highlight at the Junior Grand Prix final. And the bronze medal. And an 11th place 2 weeks ago at the European Championships.
So two to go. Adam Hagara from Slovakia. We'll skate to Dream On by Aerosmith.
Good start, triple axel, double toe.
Mm-hmm.
Adam Hagara of Slovakia
has
put down an amazing performance.
We stay on a higher level. That's cool now at the end. Really good.
Perhaps not the same technical difficulty, though, as the Korean. And put most of those jump combinations into that first half of the program.
Just one of them in the second half. And, of course, the skating skills and the artistic flair is different. But it was a good music choice for his skating. And it is amazing because Slovakia is not that typical figure skating nation. And it's amazing what this guy is about to lose. And look at this picture as he went on his knee and made a feast. And amazing. I loved it.
Well, I think, unfortunately for Ryo Nakata, who's lying in third.
No. He had 20 points ahead. He was
Adam
20
Hagara
points ahead
is
in the short
going
program.
Move up into the podium positions. The question is it good enough for gold? I'm not sure. But will it be silver or will it be bronze?
We will have one more skater afterwards. Then we know it. So we just know the first medalist, and this is the Korean guy. And I'm sure he will. I think he will have a medal too. He had 75 points in the short program. Was 7 points ahead of the New Zealand guy, who is in second position at the moment. Who was, of course, perfect, but maybe at the end, we will not know. Is it the fourth or maybe the third place? But he had two triple axel, one combination. The solo triple axel, the landing was not 100%. But he had not to step out, so that's why.
Adam Hagara will message home and hope. the relief and the excitement of having produced.
The scores, please.
Now, the scores.
Slovakia. Adam Hagara 선수의 프리스케이팅.
It's silver. Silver for Adam Hagara.
At the moment, but at least a medal.
Guaranteed a medal.
Then we have another. He will write history again. The first Slovakian skater who will win a medal at the Youth Olympics.
So 141.17 in the free skate. 216. He's only just behind Kim.
So now, the pressure is on him. The other man delivered before.
They did indeed. Jacob Sanchez is the last to skate from the United States of America. Sanchez needs to produce a perfect performance here. And he will skate to Sarabande Suite by Globus.
Yeah, it's all up the triple axel at the beginning and then the solo triple axel. It's all about the start of this free skate. Shows nerves.
That's a shame. The triple axel, double axel had the step in between and then stepped out of the triple axel.
Loop. With the hands down.
Free, 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 free
Jacob Sanchez finishes with the choreo sequence, but it went wrong at the very beginning with a triple axel and then step into the double axel. And then, in fact,
the
single triple axel and the triple toe.
The fifth jump element was the first he executed without any problems, with a safe landing. And at the end, the pressure was too high for this guy from America, so Jacob Sanchez.
Jacob Sanchez did so well
in the short program to lead
coming into this. And the pressure was on.
Yes, and of course, it's a completely new situation for him. He was in the lead ahead of all of the top contenders after the Junior Grand Prix final, ahead of Nakata, ahead of Kim, ahead of Hagara.
Yeah, let's have a look at the replays.
And this was really bad then. It should have been...
Yeah, so it should have been a triple axel, shouldn't it?
And then the second triple axel, yeah.
Yes, he opened the second up. Triple axel, he opened up, and then he fell on the triple loop.
Yeah. This was the first clean element, the combination triple Lutz, Euler, triple Sarko. That was nice, very nice. Mm-hmm. And here, that was planned double, triple. It was just double, double. And he lost a lot of points in these 3.5 minutes.
So the local fans, well...
Yeah.
they could be.
I would say at the end we have now the Korean ahead of the Slovakian and ahead of a guy from New Zealand. So that should be now the podium. And could be that Nakata at the end is in fourth position.
Well, let's see. Let's see.
Yeah.
Jacob Sanchez from the USA.
He has a very famous coach, Oleg Makarov.
The Pez skaters up there.
Jacob Sanchez 선수의 프리 스케이팅 점수는.
It's fourth for Sanchez.
By the end, it's fourth. Then it's like we said at the beginning, Nakata is in fifth place.
So a total of 200, 8 points behind Yan Hao Lee of New Zealand, who sits in the bronze medal position. And our medalists have been decided. Jacob Sanchez, with that free skate at the end, drops back from the lead into fourth.
Yeah.
And it's gold for Korea.
This is amazing.
Kim takes the gold in just 0.5 of a point, half a point ahead of Adam Hagara.
This is so amazing. This is so amazing for this young guy from Slovakia. I'm so happy for him.
And Yan Hao Lee of New Zealand takes the bronze.
Perfect.
Tal McRae of Great Britain in 12th.
That was a competition at the end, but this is amazing at the end. Three really good skaters, and they deserved it to be on the podium after their performances today in the free skate. Absolutely fantastic.
Well, I hope you've enjoyed that. We certainly did. We're going to take a quick break from commentary while they prepare for the medal ceremony, which should be taking place in around about 10 minutes' time.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie des vainqueurs va commencer.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony will begin.
잠시 후 메달 시상식을 진행할 예정입니다.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie des vainqueurs du patinage artistique, patinage individuel homme.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the figure skating, men's single skating.
여러분, 지금부터 피겨 스케이팅 싱글 남자 부문의 메달 시상식을 시작하겠습니다.
Veuillez accueillir les médaillés.
Please welcome the medalists.
여러분, 메달리스트들을 환영해 주십시오.
Time now for the medal ceremony of the men's single skating competition here at Gangwon 2024 Youth Olympic Games.
Yang Hao Lee.
And skating out with the bronze is New Zealand's Yan Hao Lee.
I'm really curious about his future career. Like said in the commentary, he has the whole package. Wonderful jumps and this artistic flair on top. This is perfect.
Born in Beijing, grew up in Auckland.
Slovakia.
Second place, Slovakia.
2위, Slovakia,
Adam Hagara.
And from Slovakia, it is Adam Hagara.
What a performance again of him. The first bronze medal winner of Slovakia in the Junior Grand Prix final, and now the silver medal at the Youth Olympic Games. He wrote history again. Congratulations.
Hagara was lying in second place after the short program, had a 75.06, so had quite a big lead over Kim of Korea in the short program, but was only third in the free skate.
First place, Republic of Korea.
And taking the gold,
Kim Hyun-yeop.
Hyun-yeop Kim of Korea took the gold in the end by just half a point.
Look at these pictures. I love it. In the Junior Grand Prix final, he was really sad after his first place in the short program to be on the second place afterwards. But here, in front of his home crowd, what a success. The gold medal winner of Gangwon 2024.
He won it with that quad toe loop, didn't he?
Yes.
To start the program off.
He had 7 points. He was 7 points behind Hagara after the short program.
And scored a 147.45. Medal presenters.
And there were no mistakes in his program too.
Ryu Singming, the IOC member, will be one of the presenters.
IOC member, and Olympian. One gold medal, one silver medal, and one bronze medal.
IOC 위원, 전 올림픽 선수. 금메달 하나, 은메달 하나, 동메달 하나.
Accompanied by.
Again, at his side, Michael Brisina, the former bronze medal winner at the European Championship, ICU athlete role model.
And that's what this Youth Olympic Games is about. It's about mentors, role models, and trying to prepare these young athletes for their careers when they go on to compete at senior level and compete for Olympic medals.
And we saw him as a coach here in this competition too, Michael Brisina. What a success for this young guy. The biggest success so far after he missed so closely the Grand Prix final with his two third places.
Lee from New Zealand takes the bronze.
I love this podium. It's a good one.
In silver medal position.
Medaille d'argent, Slovakia.
Silver medalist, Slovakia.
Medalist, Slovakia.
Adam Hagara of Slovakia takes the silver.
Adam Hagara.
Absolutely, well deserved. Can be so proud about his performance here in the short and the free skate. Two perfect programs for him.
Could not have done any better.
Gold medalist and Youth Olympic Games champion, Republic of Korea.
Gold medalist, 청소년 올림픽 champion, 대한민국.
Hyungkyun Kim is the Youth Olympic champion.
Did you see how he had to breathe before climbing up the podium, the gold medal step?
Yeah, taking the gold and producing the goods in front of the home crowd.
What an achievement. In the short program, the pressure was too high for this young guy, for this 15-year-old Hyungkyun, but not in a long one.
So time now for the national anthem of the Republic of Korea.
여러분, 대한민국의 국가 연주가 있겠습니다.
Well, not quite the tears flowing, but certainly some big, deep breaths there from Kim Jun. The Korean skater takes gold. Adam Hagara takes the silver. And Yan Hao Lee of New Zealand takes the bronze. And a quick word about Jacob Sanchez of the USA, who's leading after the short program, drops down into fourth. Rio Nakata, who had a massively disappointing short program, was able to haul himself right the way back up into fifth. But there are our medalists, Kim of Korea, Hagara of Slovakia, and Lee of New Zealand.
마쳤습니다. 내일은 아이스댄스 프린세스 경기, 여자 싱글 프리스테이킹 일정이 이어집니다.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes all events scheduled for today. Tomorrow here at Gangwon Ice Arena, the Ice Dance Free Dance and Women's Single Free Skating event will take place.